First of all, we will study about divisor, quotient and dividend. Let's see what are these three things. The number to be divided is called dividend. The number which divides the dividend is called divisor. The result is called quotient. Now see this image. In this image, you will come to know the position of divisor, dividend and quotient. Quotient is the result, the answer which we are getting after dividing. Then the second is the divisor. Divisor is the two, okay, the number which divides the dividend is called the divisor. Dividend is 12. The number to be divided is called dividend. So all these three things are placed on their position with the proper number so that you can understand. Now in the last step we have remainder. So the remainder is always less than the divisor. I hope you all remember divisor, the number which divides the dividend. Divides the dividend is called divisor and it should be less than remainder. This is long division method. We have divide 20 divided by 4 and we will get the remainder 0. We will get the remainder 0. So the remainder is always less than divisor. It is less than from divisor and divisor is 4 and remainder is 0 and it is less than from divisor. We do division in two forms, horizontal and vertical. This one is horizontal. This one is horizontal method. 6 divided by 3 is equals to 2. 2 is the answer, quotient. 3 divisor, 6 dividend. So in this we don't get remainder. Only 3 parts are there, dividend, divisor and quotient. The next one we will see, this is vertical form. This method is vertical one and in this also we have divisor 4, quotient 5, dividend 20. And if we will get a remainder, we will get the remainder 0. So answer is 5, quotient. In this also the answer is 5, quotient. So like this we do long division method. I hope it is clear to everyone. Let's do some work in maths classwork copy. So take out your maths copy.